Good evening, everybody. This is the news and the weather with Bella, connecting communities in Martha's Vineyard. Here are our picks for this week. Welcome to the show. Aqui estão as nossas notícias. Here is our update on the VTA strike story. Aqui a nossa atualização na greve dos motoristas de ônibus da VTA em Martha's Vineyard, falando sobre a greve. That's the current status of the VTA. Tensions flare between striking bus drivers, TCI, and a divisory board. In a package, Vineyard Transit Authority, VTA building meeting room, members of the VTA advisory board voted for striking drivers in the union representing them to head back to the negotiation table with Transit Connection and Company, TCI, the driver's parents' company. Only after more 2 hours of heated, intense discussion, depois de mais de horas, de 2 horas de discussão acalorada e tensa em uma reunião da VTA, da Vineyard Transit Authority, membros do Conselho Consecutivo ou Consultivo da VTA votaram por grevistas e pelo sindicato que os representa para que voltem à mesa de negociações com a TCI, a empresa controladora dos motoristas. The full-time bus drivers have been on strike since June 28th. And have been giving the support of presidential candidates and state legislators. Meanwhile, the VTA has operated its routes with seasonal drivers and managers while eliminating some key services like the Medivan that brings islanders to off-island medical appointments. Possible dates for TCI and the union to return to negotiations are July 22, 23, or July 29, 30, or 31. Their divisory board scheduled a tentative meeting for August 2nd as well, after TCI and the union met. As datas possíveis para TCI e o sindicato voltar às negociações são dia 22 de julho, 23, 29, 30 ou 31. Estão marcados e para uma preliminar para o dia 2 de agosto, depois que o TCI e o sindicato se reunissem. Land court ruling clears way for stop and shop expansion after a state land court judge denied repeated claims from an abutter that shadows and noise from the development would adversely affect his property. The long-stalled Edgartown Stop and Shop expansion project appears to be back on a front burner. That's an expression. O projeto de expansão da Edgartown Stop and Shop parece estar de volta à linha de frente depois que um juiz do Tribunal de Terras do Estado negou repetidas alegações de um vizinho de que sombras e ruídos do empreendimento afetariam negativamente a sua propriedade. In a decision issued July 12, Massachusetts Land Court Judge Honoring Diane Rubin granted summary judgment to Stop and Shop, confirmed the Edgartown Planning Board's 2018 approval of the project. Among other things, the expansion project plan calls for adding some 15,000 square feet of space to the store and redesigning and reconfiguring the parking lot and rejecting claims of aggravement by attorney and abutter, Mr. Benjamin Hall Jr. uma decisão emitida no dia 12 de julho, o juiz da Corte de Terras de Massachusetts, honorária Diane Rubin, concedeu julgamento sumário à Stop and Shop, confirmando a aprovação do projeto pelo Conselho de Planejamento de Edgar Town em 2018. And the tribe agrees to halt construction, bingo, halt site. A tribo Wampanoag concorda em parar a construção no site do Bingo Hall em Aquina. In the latest volley between the town and the tribe over the future Bingo Hall in Aquina, tribal leaders agreed this week to halt work on the site until legal issue can be resolved. No último voleio entre a cidade e a tribo sobre a futura sala de bingo, o cassino em Aquina, os líderes tribais concordaram em parar as construções e suspender o trabalho no local até que as questões legais sejam resolvidas. Last week, attorney for the tribe filed a motion in federal court requesting a stay of the ruling issued by Judge Dan Saylor IV, arguing that the tribe will suffer irreparable harm and significant monetary loss while the bingo hall remains unbuilt. The tribe argued that it follows its own regulatory standards that are as good or better than local codes. Na semana passada, os advogados da tribo apresentaram uma moção em um tribunal federal solicitando a suspensão da decisão emitida pelo juiz Dan Saylor IV, argumentando que a tribo sofrerá danos irreparáveis e perdas monetárias significativas enquanto a sala de bingo ainda não foi construída. A tribo argumentou que segue seus próprios padrões regulatórios, que são bons ou melhores que os códigos locais. A stay would allow construction to begin while the tribe appeals to the U.S. Court of Appeals First Circuit. There has been no ruling yet from Judge Saylor. Ainda não houve nenhuma decisão do juiz Saylor. Vamos aguardar. E aqui mais comunidade que acontece. Here, more community happening, circulando locally na nossa história de hoje. On the today's story, Global Water Dance, MV 2019's performance that happened at the Weyburn Park, no Bluffs. Watch. Estamos aqui no Weyburn Park, no Parque Weyburn, em Oak Bluffs, para assistir a performance da Water Dance Global, da Dança das Águas. Globalmente falando, vai acontecer em 170 países. Thank you.
so that we just did a beautiful dance promoting the beauty of our water dance, and that we all want to have healthy water wherever we are in this world. So this is Global Water Dances. Thank you all for coming out.
Today is Global Water Day, and what does it mean to me? Well, it sounds cliche, but water is life. And as a water bearer, one who brings life through birth, I'm honored to be here amongst the home of my ancestors, by the water, recognizing our giving thanks to it. Because without the water, the organisms and the life that is in the water will perish. And once that happens, we're soon to follow. So please, show love and respect for our water each and every day. Every glass that you take, recognize that water and thank it for giving you the nutrients for us and for generations to come.
We love to say thank you to Scott Crawford. Thank you for the message and all participants of the Global Water Dance. A matéria é da BBC.com, português. Para Bolsonaro, você não vê gente mesmo pobre pelas ruas do Brasil, com físico esquelético, como se vê em outros países pelo mundo. Essas são as palavras do presidente do Brasil, Jair Bolsonaro, que disse na última sexta-feira que falar que se passa fome no Brasil é uma grande mentira. A declaração foi dada durante um encontro com jornalistas no Palácio do Planalto, em Brasília. Passa-se mal, não se come bem. Aí eu concordo. Agora, passar fome, não. Você não vê gente, mesmo pobre, pelas ruas com físico esquelético, como se vê em outros países do mundo, disse o presidente. Criticado pela declaração, Bolsonaro reviu sua opinião horas depois, em outro evento, ao reconhecer que uma pequena parte dos brasileiros passa fome. Ele se irritou ao ser questionado por jornalistas se havia recuado da declaração inicial. Se for para entrar em detalhe, ele disse, em filigranas, eu vou embora. Não estou vendo nenhum magro aqui. Temos problemas alimentares no Brasil? Temos. Não é culpa minha. Vem de trás, ele disse durante a reunião com os jornalistas. For your understanding, words from Brazil President Bolsonaro. You do not see people, even poor people, in the streets of Brazil with the skeletal physique as seen in other countries around the world. President Jair Bolsonaro said on Friday that talking about starvation in Brazil is a big lie. The statement was made during a meeting with journalists at the Planalto Palace in Brazil. In Brasília, the capital of Brazil. You do not see people, even poor people, on the streets with the skeletal physique that you see in other countries around the world, said the president. Criticized by the statement, Bolsonaro revealed his opinion hours later in another event when he recognized that a small part of Brazilian goes hungry. He was annoyed when the journalist asked him if he had backed away from the initial statement. If it is to get into details in I'm leaving, I'm not seeing anything people here. We have food problems in Brazil. We have, it's not my fault if we do have it. Comes from behind. What a heat wave, Martha's Vineyard! Here it is, Martha's Vineyard weather forecast for this week ahead. Enjoy! Aproveite! É verão! Esta é a previsão do tempo para Martha's Vineyard, para essa semana.
Tonight, Monday, hoje, noite, segunda-feira, shower, thunderstorm, cloud and patch fog. and a low around 69. Previsão de chuvas para esta noite, com formação de neblina e mínimas nos 69 graus. Ventos vão vir pelo leste, depois da meia-noite pelo sudeste. Tuesday, terça-feira, showers and possibly a thunderstorm. And patch fog before 9 a.m. High near 74. North wind 8 to 11 miles per hour with gusts as high as 23 miles per hour. Chuvas com raios e trovoadas são esperadas para terça-feira e as máximas vão estar nos 74 graus. Para a noite de terça, Tuesday night, a chance of showers, mostly cloudy with a low around 65. Tempo nublado e sujeito a chuvas, com mínimas nos 65 graus. Wednesday, quarta-feira, slight chance of showers before 10 a.m. Partly sunny, with a high near 76. North wind, 5 to 7 miles per hour. Becoming southeast in the afternoon. Uma pequena chance de chuvas por volta das 10 da manhã, com o tempo permanecendo nublado e os ventos vindo pelo norte entre 5 a 7 milhas por hora. Máxima chegando aos 76 graus. Wednesday night, noite quarta-feira, partially cloudy with a low around 65. Tempo parcialmente nublado, com mínimas nos 65 graus. Thursday, quinta-feira, mostly sunny on Thursday with a high near 78. Sol para quinta-feira, com temperaturas máximas chegando nos 78 graus. And most clear with a low around 67. On Thursday night, tempo bom com mínimas nos 67 graus para a noite de quinta-feira. Friday, sunny with a high near 79. Sexta-feira ensolarada, máximas nos 79 graus.
Open mic night, every other Tuesday, let's go there at the Island Music in Vinhaven. Every other Tuesday, open mic night. Keep it up for World Mic Mondays at the Grand House in West Cheese every Monday, third season. Save date for Pathways annual event at the Cheeseberry Water Works. You'll be on Sunday, September 15th. And check pathwaysmv.org, updates and information. This week on July 26th, Friday, MVY Night at the Chumar Community Center, hosted by MVY Radio at 7:30 p.m. to 10. And Chumar plus give a try, Aquina Artisan Fair at the Aquina Town Hall. What you need is there. Saturdays 10 to 2, to July to August. Thanks to Alsers, the National Weather Link, Christopher's beautiful image background, MVTV, thanks to Carl Holt, Martha's Vineyard, Savings Bank, Martha's Vineyard Cultural Council, and to Chronics Market. Thank you all for all your support. A chegada do homem à lua completou 50 anos neste sábado. 50 years ago, man landed on the moon. Congratulations, NASA. Time goes by. Connect with us at Planet Bella TV on YouTube channel and on Facebook. Follow us, like us. You can help supporting local news. Contact us at planetbella@hotmail.com. Learn more. The news and the weather with Bella, connecting communities since 2014. This program is dedicated to the community. Este programa é dedicado à comunidade. Happy week, folks! Tchau, tchau for now. See you next.